Today we are going to take up the box with continuously varying cross section, wherein we need to find out what is the stress and total elongation in an uniformly tapering circular or round section bar. So here you can see there is a taper bar having a diameter d1 at the larger end and d2 at the smaller end, and having a length of the bar is equal to L, and we are considering a section at a distance of x and having the thickness of dx, and this will be the diameter at the section. So this is subjected to axial load capital P on either directions. This is something which is very similar. Now we have taken this as a three split up conditions, wherein we have a uniform bar of diameter d2 here. So we have considered this as the uniform diameter, which is here, which will be d2, and from here to here. And we have one right angle triangle here, and we have the one more right angle triangle which will be at this point. So this is the section what we have been considered in the three different sections. So the length, the slope what we have here, so this will going to be the M, and here this will going to be d2, and here again this is going to be M. So that is what we have shown here. So this is the separate cross section where we have the uniform diameter d2, M and M. So here, let the modulus of elasticity of the material be, let the modulus of elasticity, of the material, B E, and the applied axial force, capital P. Now, so we have the change in diameter. Diameter will be equal to over the length. Change in diameter over the length. L. So that will be equal to, what is the change in diameter over the length? L. So that means we have d1 here and d2 here. So what will go to be the change in diameter? The change in diameter is this and also this. So that means d1 minus d2 by L. So d1 minus d2, that is the change in diameter. So now the rate of change of diameter, diameter will be equal to, that is K, it will be equal to d1 minus d2 by L. So what is the rate of change of diameter? So here we have the length of the diameter, the length of the tapering rod will be equal to L. Suppose if I consider any one segment, then what will going to be the change in diameter, or the rate of change of diameter on that particular section will be d1 minus d2 by L. So now consider an elemental length of bar. Consider an elemental length of bar dx at a distance x from the bigger end, at a distance of x from the larger end. So that means, so we are considering the section at this particular member at a distance of x from the bigger end, that is d1. So now this can be analyzed we will going to consider this now. So this is what the section what we have considered at a distance of x from the larger n. Now considering the similar triangles. So here the similar triangles are ABC. Considering the similar triangles ABC and BDE. So here we have AC by L will be equal to DE by DB. So that will be equal to AC by L will be equal to what is DE is nothing but M by DB, the length of this will be equal to L minus X. But what we want is we want M. Therefore, M will be equal to that is ED. So we can consider this as ED only. So ED is nothing but ED will be equal to M, which will be equal to L minus X. So we are cross multiplying L minus X by L into AD. Sorry, AC. So what is AC? AC is nothing but that is the change in diameter. So that is this distance. Suppose if you are considering together, it will be D1 minus D2. But since we are considering the two sections on this side and also on this side, now we are arriving only for this particular portion. So that will be equal to D1 by 2 minus D2 by 2. So that is what we have written here. So that will be equal to L minus X by L into D1 by 2 minus D2 by 2. So that is here, that will be equal to. So here, if you are considering this, the total, so this is D2 and this is D1 minus, so this will be equal to. So we have this and we have this. So the entire section is D2. This is D2. So now we want this portion, that is D1 minus D2 will give you this portion and this portion. But I want only for this. So that will be equal to D1 minus D2 by 2. Again D1 minus D2 by 2 on these two portions. So when you add these two, you are going to get D1 minus D2. So that is how, if you are considering this, D1 minus D2 by 2 plus D1 minus D2 by 2, if you are considering this. So we are getting 2 is the common factor, LCM, D1 minus D2 plus D1 minus D2. So here, so that will be equal to D1 minus D2 by 2. So that will be 2D1. So that will be equal to here 2D1 minus D2 by 2. So you will know the value as equal to D1 minus D2. So this is the expression what you will want to get if you are considering both. Since we are dividing it by 2, so that means we want only this portion. So we will go to get D1 by 2 minus D2 by 2. So that is how we will go to get this. Now the next is, so now we will go to open up. Open the bracket. If you are trying to open this bracket, then you can see 1 minus. So this can be written as 1 minus X by L into D1 by 2, D1 by 2 minus D2 by 2. So now we are multiplying this. Now we are again opening out this. So that will be equal to D1 by 2 minus D2 by 2. Then minus X by 2 minus X by L into D1 by 2. Then minus into minus becomes plus X into X by L into D2 by 2. So this is the expression we are going to get. Now this value will be equal to M. So this value will be equal to m. So now here, now we are taking the common factor, we are taking the LCM of this. So once we are considering the LCM, so that will be equal to m, which will be equal to, now 2 is the common LCM here. So I am going to take 2 as the LCM, that is d1 minus d2. Then we have 2 into, that is minus x by l, x into d1, so x into d1, x into d1. So here we can take it as d1 by 2, we can take it out like this. So d1 by 2, d1 by 2 minus, so here d1 by 2, we will going to take it like this, d1 minus d2. So since we have a 2, we will going to cross multiply this 2m. So that will be equal to minus x into d1 by l plus x into d2 by l. X into d2 by l. So now, once we get this, so what is the diameter of the section? The diameter of the section, what we are going to get, which will be this diameter, which will be equal to d2 plus m plus m. So that means it will be 2m plus d2. So now when you are considering this to the left hand side, you will get to get 2m plus d2 equals d1 minus, I can take minus x by l into d1 minus d2. So the above expression can be written in like in this form. So that will be equal to, so d1 minus x by d1 by x by l into d1 minus d2. So what is this 2m plus d2? So this 2m plus d2, that is this m plus this m will become 2m plus d2. 2m plus d2 will going to become the diameter of the section. So that will be equal to 2m plus d2 is nothing but, 2m plus d2 is nothing but, plus d2 will be equal to d, which will be the diameter of the section. So therefore, let d be the diameter, let d be the diameter, be the diameter of the bar, of the bar at the section. Let the diameter, let d be the diameter of the bar at this section considered. At this section considered. So that will be equal to d, it will be equal to d1 minus, d1 minus, d1 minus d2 by l into x. So the above expression can be written in this form. So that will be equal to area of the cross section. So that will be equal to area of cross section of the bar, area of the cross section, area of the cross section of the bar at a distance x, at a distance x, at a distance x from larger n, from larger n. So that will be equal to A, which is nothing but pi d square by 4. So pi d square by 4. So here what happens? So this will be equal to d1 minus, d1 minus d2 by l is nothing but k into x. You can write it in this form. So where k will be equal to d1 minus d2 by l, where k will be equal to d1 minus d2 by l. So now we are going to substitute this here. So that will be equal to pi by 4 into d1 minus a into x, the whole square. So that will be the area of cross section at the section considered. So now we will going to apply the elongation. Therefore, elongation of the element. Therefore, elongation of the element. Elongation of the element. So that means what is the elongation if you going to take place at this particular section. So that will be equal to P into, that will be P into dx by area of cross section, which will be pi by 4 into d1 minus k into x, the whole square into e. This is the formula what we have taken, delta L equal to P into L by A into E. So this is the general expression what we have considered here. So what is P? P is the axial force which is applied, which is this. And then length of the member, the length of the cross section what we are considering here is dx. Then the area of cross section of the bar, that is this area of cross section, which will be pi by 4 into d1 minus k into x the whole square into Young's modulus of the material. Next, now this is for only for the one element what we are considering. So, but for the entire cross section if you are considering, then what happens, that will be equal to the total elongation of the bar. So the total elongation of the bar delta L, total elongation of the bar, elongation of the bar delta L will be equal to, so what is the total elongation? The sum of the elements which will going to be considered individually and then summing up. So that can be done by using an integration. So what is the integration? Integration between the integration of P into dx divided by area of cross section pi by 4 into d1 minus k into x the whole square into E. So this is the integral. That means we are adding from where to where? From here to here. So that is from 0. Suppose if I am considering this as 0 and this as L. So it will be the limit 0 to L. So this is the addition what we are considering by doing the integration. So now, so 4 will go to the top. So 4 into P into dx divided by pi into d1 minus k into x the whole square into E. So we know there are certain elements which are constants here. P is the axial force which is applied on the member having a constant for that particular element. That is the tensile mode what is applied. Pi anyhow it's a constant, and E is the Young's modulus of the material which is also a constant. So we will go to take that outside the integration side. 4P by pi into E is the integration outside the integration because it is a constant. P, sorry, dx by d1 minus k into x the whole square. So this is of the order of integration of x to the power of n, which will be minus n plus 1 by n plus minus n plus 1 into d by dx of x. So this is of that form. So that will be equal to 4p into pi into e into k into 1 by d1 minus k into x. So this is between the limits 0 to n. So now we are going to apply the equation of the upper limit and the lower limit. So the upper limit and the lower limit, which is when it is applied, so what we will going to get? Wherever you have the x term, we will going to have that term here. So that will be equal to k. So now we will going to apply this. That will be equal to 4p by pi e k into 1 by d1 minus k into L. Then lower limit, again 4p pi into e into k, which is the common factor, 1 by x is 0, so that will be equal to 1 by d1. So this is how we are going to get. So now we will going to apply the value of k. So what is the value of k? The value of k is nothing but d1 minus d2 by L. So 4p by pi into e into k is nothing but d1 minus d2 by L, that into 1 by d1 minus k value is again d1 minus d2 by L by L minus 1 by d1. So we will go to get this. Now what happens? This L and this L will get cancelled. So that will be equal to 4 into P into L divided by pi into E into D1 minus D2 into 1 by D1 minus D1 minus into minus becomes plus plus D2 minus 1 by D1. So then D1 D1 gets cancels here. So that will be equal to so what happens? 4 into that is delta L will be equal to 4P into L divided by pi E into D1 minus D2 into, now we have 1 by D2 minus 1 by D1. Now we will go to take the LCM out of this. So that will be equal to 4 into P into L divided by pi into E into D1 minus D2 into, now you take a LCM, that is D1 into D2. So again D2 D2 gets cancels, you will go to get D1. D1 divided by D1 is cancels and minus D2 you will go to get. So this will be equal to this. So now we have D1 minus D2. So what happens? Now this D1 minus D2 and D1 minus D2 gets cancels. 4P into L by pi E into 1 by D1 D2. So this, the final expression what we can write here will be equal to 4PL by, so therefore delta L will be equal to 4 into P into L divided by pi into E into D1 into D2. So this is the total elongation of the bar, total extension of the tapering bar of circular cross section. Therefore total extension of a tapering bar of circular cross section which is delta L will be equal to 4 into P into L divided by pi E into D1 into D2. So this is the final expression what you will get. Now the next condition is, suppose, so what we will going to apply when we want to have the maximum stress. So the maximum stress, where it will going to act, the maximum stress is going to be acting only when we have the least cross section. So where is the least cross section? The least cross section will be always the smaller diameter, which is D. The maximum stress in the bar, sigma max will be equal to applied load, divided by least area of cross section. So that means what is that? So sigma will be equal to applied load is P, that is because we are applying the tensile load P, divided by the least area of cross section is the diameter D2 is the smaller end and the diameter D1 is the larger end. So that will be equal to pi by 4 into D2 square. So here, since it is the stress, P into L by E into E, so that means the applied load P by the least area of cross section, which will be the sigma maximum stress. So this will going to be the final expression. So note for this, suppose if you have a uniform bar, so that will be here, delta L will be equal to, for uniform bar, diameter bar, delta L will be equal to P into L divided by pi d square by 4 by into E. So what does it mean? So now, suppose if you are considering a uniform bar means, suppose if you have a bar of uniform cross section, so that means wherein you have the The bar of length L, bar of length L having a axial tensile load which is applied P, wherein the length of the bar is L, having a diameter D, which will going to be the area of cross section. So then this will be the equation for uniform diameter bar, where P into L by pi d square by 4 into E is the Young's modulus of the material. So for tapering bar, delta L will be equal to, for tapering bar, delta L will be equal to 4 into P, that is P into L by pi by 4 into D1 into D2 into E. So that is again nothing but 4 into P into L divided by pi into D into D2 into E. So this is the expression what we have for a tapering bar. Hence for tapering bar, D1 and D2 has been used instead of D. So this is how you will be able to solve or derive this particular expression for stress and also the total elongation.